Music feeds love and makes it stronger. And keep playing music. Give me so much of it. So much that it kills. A long way below and makes it go away. Make it fun again. How restless you are.
I mean,
you touch up everything like this. But then the next minute, everything seems to be worthless. No matter how valuable it is. Love is like a hallucination. Nothing else is imaginative and extravagant. I'm already hunting a heart. But it's also my heart. When I first saw you, it seemed to me that she cared for the air with her bare presence. In that instant, I was transformed into a heart. And ever since then, my desire has pursued me like a pack of wolves. Out. What's going on? Can you stop?
Sorry, my lord. They wouldn't let me enter. But Olivia-san may get me this answer. The outside world will see Olivia's face for the next 7 years. She'll wear a veil like a nun, and once a day she'll bother her daughter. All of this is to preserve her love for her granddaughter. His memory is one to keep present forever.
Oh, the heart inside Olivia is beautiful, but loves her body this much. Then imagine how she loved me, but if its arm was killed on her other emotion. Except love, her mind, her body, each of them across his kingdom. And we'll all be ruled by one man, and that's me. Now take me to a garden of flowers, my thoughts of love will be strengthened by a beautiful set.
I do, yes, as nobody in the garden has seen.
only last for a month. And at that time, there was a popular rumor. As you know, Ben could have to call some of our movie that he was courting the fair lady.
Yeah.
A gorgeous young woman, daughter of a count who died a year ago. Who left her and her son, Polygraph brother. But the brother died soon after. They say that out of love for a brother, Olivia stopped the crafting the man altogether.
Oh, I wish I had stabbed that lady. I wouldn't have to reveal myself to the world until the time was right to identify the basis of society.
That would be hard to bring about, because she won't allow anyone in to see her, not even the Duke's men.
Seems to be a good man. Old behavior, even though nature often makes beautiful people crumble inside, I believe that you have an open mind to protect yourself. So please, please. Help me conceal my identity and finally divide this guy's own friend by extension. I want to sell this dude. Well, introduce me to him as a eunuch. You won't be wasting his time hard fighting and saying his big mouth. He will surely consider me for his service. After that, only silence will happen. I must only imagine a way to silence and switch.
You will be a eunuch, and I will give you a testament. If I tell your secret, may I lose my sight.
Sir Andrew Agapay himself!
now, yun. We want to come to Osmeral. So, according to me, we're ready to be the men.
Are you afraid of school? It isn't my fault. If you take the second chance, it'll stop liking me. Do you usually pick any of your face?
Oh, believe me.
I thank you for telling me this. Here comes the here I am, my lord, at your service.
Cesario, you know everything about me. I have opened my secret soul to you. Therefore, idiot, break your step to leave his house. Don't let them deny your success. Stand outside the door and tell them that your plan is there, and they will let you see.
But my overlord, she is as sweet as broken hearted as they say. She is sure to deny me an audience.
Oh, they describe the passion of Malaga, huh? I'm gonna share with the description of my feelings. It would be best if you out of my feelings. They should pay closer to you, see? That got older, more serious messenger.
I don't think so, my lord.
Dear boy, believe me, anyone who says that you're a man, deny that I'm here to be your guts. Your lips are as good, and you'll be read as God's Ionis. You dance like a girl, hide here. And the rest of you is not. I know that your government is taking you. Four of you, go with me. The rest of you can live here for once. You want to move that in the way? Sorry, you. If you succeed in this, you'll be as well as a view. But share me no more fortune.
I will do my best in trying to win this lady for you. Yet, what a conflict! I must go courting if you have a woman that I want to marry myself!
Take the lady away!
It's enough! You're all done!
bought some alcohol and got a vital fix. If you give the dry food a drink, it won't be dry anymore. And if you give the unreliable man some good advice, and his ways will be unreliable anymore. Anything that's mended,
something that's
not. A virtuous man who does something wrong is only passed up with sin. A sinner can mend his ways only passed up with mercy. This large God can eventually miss you. But if not, what can be done? Only truly betrayed us in fear is the one deserted by love. So you won't remain alone for long, my lady. But sadly, the Lord is taking the away, so again, gentlemen, take the lady away.
Sir, I told them to take you away.
Not the error of the worst kind. Lady, I'm judging by his cover. He hurts me. That's to say that I'm just his total inside. Holy lady.
Can you do it?
Easily, my good lady.
Then do it.
Well, I must ask you some questions then. Please answer them.
Well, sir, I got nothing better to do, so I'm not allowed this.
Well then, dear lady, why are you
dear, because of your brother's death.
I think his soul is in hell.
I know his soul is in heaven.
In your room, you will know that your body's soul be in heaven. Now again, take away the food, gentlemen.
Do you think of this food? Was it taken out of bed?
Yes, and he went to the very dust. Only his senility, for it was given by April Fools. Then may God send you only your senility, that you might become a better fool than me. Sir Toby would have better fortune than I'm not a clever man, but he would have been too stent. Two cents that you're not a fool.
What do you think of this
fool? I'm surprised that your leadership enjoys to compliment such a good-spirited villain. Beyond this, sir, you are somewhat in wits to an ordinary agent on the word brand itself. But now, he's without words in a charge of rent. Unless you love him, give him an opportunity. He can take what he can say. I declare it's all old wise men who love so hard as jesters, who rehearse the scenes and are better than jesters' assistants themselves.
Oh, dear sacred man, to my father, and if I had your duties, if you were generous, innocent, and friendly, then you would have made such a mountain instead of a molehill. There's no real harm in a professional fool, even if it is nothing but mock people. In the same way, there's no real mockery in a wise man. Even if
he does
nothing
to
nice people.
Well, the Mercury, that god of deception, make you a skilled liar. Just look at you, make you so highly wizard.
Madam,
you
see, I'm sure that you're not going to try to speak with him. Is he second to Christina? I don't know, Madam. We're just like people just delaying here right now. Sir, talk about it. You have to. He talks like a madman! Shame on him! You go, my lord! If this visitor is such a good, but the two, the dragon, then I will seek with others at home! Do whatever you have to do to make him go away! Now you see, sir, how the dogs are still and the people dislike
him! Well, holy lady, look, it's like a fool! As if your eldest son was going to be a fool like me! You think God has to go for the graves!
I swear, Miss Hopjo, who's that in the gate, Hopjo?
A gentleman!
A gentleman? What gentleman?
There's a gentleman here! Damn those pickled Harry! They upset my stomach! How's it going, you drunken fool? Good, Sir Toby!
Hopjo! Hopjo! It's so early in the day! How are you already so sick?
Tricks? I hate tricks! There's a man at the gate!
Yes! I heard! But who is he?
Let him be the devil if he wants to be. I know him! God will give me the way to resist him! It doesn't matter to me!
Tell him to drop on his knife!
He's like a drunk man! Like me! Or a madman! The first one is a fool! That's why you speak with you. I told him you were asleep. He claims to have already too. What did you say to him, my lady?
Just tell him wrong all of my excuses.
I told him not to worry about his sins. The sun called him a sun for his Lord. The lamp of the bench until he had a sound.
What kind of man is he?
What? What's his manners?
But what is his manners?
He has a very bad manners. He says, he speaks to you whether you like it or not.
But what does he look like? And how old is he?
He's not old enough to be a man. He's not young enough to be a boy either. He's like a pea pod and an apple just before it's ripe. He's like, it's not time. It's
not time. Written was very old.
Please don't scorn him.
Just tell him what the fuck. I have to get some skin to face. Oh!
My lady, but I want sun. I'm writing it and it's wetting.
Then it's for a night to be fit. Please, keep it to yourself. I heard that you were rude at the gates and I left you in because I was curious about you. Not to be a customer. You care that crazy? Then go! If you're safe, beg me. I am not in the mood for lively conversation. Will you sense me a little now, sir?
No, I'll talk to you a little longer. When Eddie, would you call up from Giant Hill?
Tell me what?
I am a messenger.
Then you must have a heartfelt message to deliver. Since you saw me, then why? Speak your business.
It only concerns you.
From my brilliant declaration of war, demand for grace, I'm only bringing you an olive branch, my brother. Full of peace.
Everyone, even
said
the family of the soldiers. Now, sir, what is your secret?
Oh, sweet lady!
This sounds like a important document of fate! One that deserves to be spoken of. Where is the secret text where the message comes from?
My lady, no secret.
Oh, in his heart? In what chapter in which it is his heart?
Oh, to continue this metaphor, the first chapter of his heart.
Oh, I have read the book. It's not a new message. It's heresy. Do you have anything more to say?
Good, madam. Let me see your face.
Did your lord argue you to his gate with my face? You, Ronald, you're screened now. Best object to bring and enjoy the picture. Look, sir, this is the portrait of me in the present moment. Isn't it Wilbert?
It's excellently done. That's the way God made it.
It's natural, sir. Wind and wind will wash it.
It's truly beautiful. Your white skin and your red lips. Painted by nature's skillful hand. Oh, you would be the cruelest woman alive if you just let your beauty go with you in the grave. Instead of having children passing it on.
Oh, sir, I won't be so cruel. I'll get this out of my beauty. I'll make a deed of adventure and every part of heaven added to my belt. For example, item, two lips, one ring on your back. Item, two gray eyes with this attached. Item, one neck, one cheek. Will you only stand here to praise my beauty?
I see what you are. You are so proud. And even if you were devil, you'd still be beautiful. My master and lord loves you with such love that couldn't be repaid even if you were crowned the most beautiful in the world.
How does he love me?
With thunderous groans, with passionate sighs, and with abundant tears.
Your lord knows my heart. I cannot love him. I'm sure that he is a gracious man, noble, rich, and young. Nothing can be in reports that he is generous, both gracious in his manner and good looking. But this Michael God, I can get along. He should not accept my answer irrevocable.
If I love you with my master passion, your rejection would make no sense at all. I do not understand it.
Well, what would you do if you were your master?
Well, I would build a little cabin outside of your gates. I would call out to you my son into your house. I would sing a weird love song, even in the dead of night. And I would call out to you your name into the hills and make the echoes cry out. Oh, Olivia, you wouldn't be able to go near under the sun without even pitying me.
It's a lot of you would do. What are your parents?
My lady, go to her while you wear. I'm still well off. I am a gentleman.
Go back to your heart. I cannot love him. Tell him that you sent enemy messengers. Unless perhaps you were driven and how face their rejection. Farewell. Here is something you still.
No, my lady. You must be mistaken. I'm no paid messenger. Give you money. It's my master is going without his
durable. And the man you fall in love with have a heart of stone. And man your passion like my master is scornfully rejected. Farewell. What? Rather your parents. I was born to a higher power than they have them. But I am still better. I am a gentleman. Yes, you are. Your words, your face, your spirits all seems like a cost of art for a lord. But not so fast. Calm down. Calm down. If only your sin or your desire. But what's going on? Can someone touch the plague of hope this quickly? I think I can feel this youth's melted and invisibly into my eyes. But let it happen. Come!
Dear madam, at your service.
And after the irritating messenger who just left, the gentleman, he left this ring behind, whether I like it or not. Tell him I want nothing to do with it. And tell the youth that if he'll come by tomorrow, I'll give him reasons why. Now hurry up, my boy.
Madam, I will.
I don't know what I'm doing. I'm falling in love with some tiny good looks. Using my eyes instead of using my head. Fate, do what you will. We can control our destinies. What must be will be, so let it happen.
Therefore, you see your man. We stay fate alone. We have others taking you. Not that you have any troubles. At least let me know where you're headed. Surely, I can, sir. But my eyes want to become a worldling, want to become a nation.
Fire, water, earth, and air.
Go ahead.
That's what they say. They think I'm participating and drinking. You are a smart man! Let us eat and drink them!
Maria, I say, bring us a big mug of wine!
Here comes the food! Actually... How's it going, my sweethearts? Look at this! Look at it! We are like this picture! We three! Three food together! Welcome, you jackass!
Now sing us a song!
I swear! Full as an excellent voice! I would give you 40 shillings to accept this beautiful singing voice! Truly, that was some really good pulling last night when you spoke that political nonsense about being Romitos and Pepians as a production of Gimbus. It was very funny! Really! Send some money to spend on your speed. Did you get it?
Yes!
I will give them my pockets! All you can keep is those I'm betting they were. My lady has lovely white hands. Ancient warriors are classical, no classical. Excellent! Why is nonsense? Yes, I do. When all said and done. Now, sing us a song!
Come on! Here's 6 pence for you. Let's have a song!
Some money from here. If one night skips in.
Do you want a love song or a drinking song? A love song! A love song!
Yes, yes. I don't care. You're just sleeping.
Oh, mistress mine, where are you roaming? Oh, stay and listen. Love's coming. He can sing. Journeys end when lovers meet. As every wise man's son should know.
Mas excellent!
Good! What is love is not the future. Joy in the present means present laughter. What is to come is still true. There's no reward for wasting time. Kiss me while you're sweet and twenty. Beautiful beauty will not endure.
A sweet voice, if I ever heard one.
A catchy song.
Yes, sweet and catchy.
If we could hear with our noses, this plague bread would be sweet indeed. But will we wake up the sky dance with our antics? Will we wake up the night owl and sing loud enough? Will we make people brave? Will we?
Friends, let's do it. I am a dog at singing catches.
We'll do it then.
Some dogs are good at singing catches. Certainly. Our culture.
You villain.
You mean? Shut your mouth, you villain. Right. If we sing that, we don't have to call you a villain, knight. It won't be the first time.
Villain. You begin, fool. It begins.
Well, I won't ever begin if I shut my mouth.
It's a good one, but come on, begin. They sing the catch, they sing the song.
Hey, let the rocks be making drums here. We need to be the food of your store, Malgoyo. It's funny to get you out of this house. It's true.
My lady Olivia is a trickster. We are clever plotters. Malgoyo is a loose woman. And we are three merry men! Aren't we, David? I'm Olivia's uncle, right? Well, laddie the lady! There lived a man in Babylon, lady the lady!
My, my! The knight's very good at playing the fool! Yes, he's good enough! And he feels like it, he has more experience. It comes to me naturally.
On the 12th day of December!
Lockman, be quiet!
Masters! Are you crazy? What's wrong with you?
have you knowing, manner, or honesty, such as around this time of night? I tried to turn my house into a not stopping by singing as a road song, without bothering to learn voice at all. Do you have our respect for people, this place, or this time of night?
We did respect the time, sir, in the midst of our souls. So go hang yourself,
sir. Toby, I must complain with you. My lady told me that she let you stay here because you are her relative, but she doesn't approve your disorder. If you can start cleaning yourself up, you are welcome in the house. But if not, you should prefer to leave, and may my lady glad to bid you farewell.
Farewell, sweetheart, since I have to go now.
No, sir Toby.
It's nice to show the results of a sober.
This is really happening.
But I will never die. Sir Toby, that's a lie. Should I tell him to go?
This is not being a case.
And what if you do? Should I tell him to go and not spare his feelings? Oh, no, 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 don't you dare. You're out of joke, sir. You lie. You're nothing more than a steward. Do you think that just because you are boring and virtuous, food and wine will disappear? By St. Tam will have spite to you too! You've got the right idea! Go rob your steward's chain with some crumbs, sir! Ria, bring us more wine!
Miss Maria, if you care at all about Lady Olivia Rufa, then you want to bring more wine and compliment this poor spirit. Tell her about this, I tell her.
Go eagle, you donkey is.
Speaking of good and open wine, with the beauties that he was giving mine to the nurse, I will challenge him to a duel. That is your luck. That might work.
Do it, knight! I'll write a letter challenging him on your behalf.
Thank you.
I'm turning into a star right now. Not high, you love jokes. Goodbye, man, now. Here comes the fist, I must be close. We're taking it.
Oh, this stuff. Oh, Lila. Maria wants to be the lady who lives like me. Now, it's her to leave yourself, man. She should not have been. You must not be a not. Besides, she treats me with more respect and admiration than anyone else in the service. So, what do you think about this?
Come on.
What an arrogant feeling. Give me a pain.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
I could be Count Malvolio!
Ah, that feeling!
Somebody shoot him! Just shoot him!
There are other instances of such things happening. The lady says she married her ward of
mercy.
Imagine me, after 3 months of being married to her, sitting in my majestic chair.
Oh, if only I had a slingshot to shoot him in the eye.
All of my servants around me, dressed in my embroidered velvet gown, having a scar from the sofa where I live, Olivia sleeping.
Bloody hell!
Some this person with authority and gravely serving their own inside at the open place. And the lights are now dead. I'd ask for my cousin to turn.
Oh my God!
No. Seven of my servants, pleading them to go to find me, are found on the way to perhaps win my watch. Of now with mine, so much jewel in my head. Some of you approaches me in bows.
Let this fellow leave.
We must. I reach my hand to him like so, distinguishing my use of hand and placing it in the severe and the authority.
That's what I'm hoping you can punch in the mouth, eh?
Past fortune has allowed you to marry your niece. I have the right to say this.
What?
You must give up your drinking.
Out of here, you scum!
Another scene. You're wasting your valuable time with a foolish knight. Not Sir Anne. And what do we have here?
Now the bird that takes the sleep. Oh, why is he doing that? I hope I'm not.
By God, this is Melinda's handwriting. It's her seas, her use, and her teeth. And this is how she makes her make peace. It's her handwriting, without question. To my beloved, but does it know my love? The same sense of my good wishes. And expresses you and express just how she would speak. Excuse me for making seal wax. But wait! This wax is now an image of the priest, which Olivia uses for a seal. This is where it's handwriting. God knows that I love, but who lives in this place? No man. No man must know. But what's next? The boys are changing. No man must know. What if she's writing to you, Malvolio?
No!
I may command the one I love, but silence, like a knife.
cuts my heart with a bloody spoon. M-O-A-R rules my life. Such a clever girl, I say. M-O-A-R rules my life. Okay. But first, let me see. This one is... She's my lady. It's much easier for anyone to figure out. But the end, what does that mean? Funding a big prepared answer. Wait. M-O-A-R. Ah! Oh, I knew it. Back.
Come. God bless you and your new music, sir. Do you make your living by playing a drum?
No, sir. I live by the church.
Are you a clergyman? Not at all, sir.
I live by the church.
Video ko pala dyan.
Hindi ko. You might as well say that the king sleeps with a beggar because the beggar lives near him. Well, that the church stands next to the drum. It's the drum stands next to the church.
Truly, sir. No wonder he's born in ages! Sentence is trying to suck love with your wits. I think that they turned inside out to move on out.
Well, stands in the truth. Those who play with words can make them easily changeable and promiscuous.
That's so, sir. The name of my sister didn't have a name.
Why, man?
Well, her name's a word. And to mess around with that word might make my sister promiscuous. Well, indeed. Words have been rascals ever since people started paying the contracts guaranteed them.
What's your reason for that, man?
Well, sir, I can't give you a reason without using words. And since words have been so false and unreliable, I'm hesitant to use them for my own.
I bet you're a happy fellow without a care in the world.
No, sir, but I do care for something. But to be honest, I don't care for you. If that means that I care for nothing, then you should be invisible right now. For nothing.
Aren't you the lady in every school?
No, sir. The lady Olivia is so foolish. She won't keep a fool until she gets married. You know, fools are to husbands as anchovies are to sardines. Husbands are just larger versions of us fools.
I saw you were two casinos earlier.
Well, you did, maybe. But I'd be sorry for your master was less acquainted with foolishness than my mistress is.
Are you making fun of me? If you are, then I want nothing to do with it. But here, I have some words for you.
Well, may God in his sanctuary for the fair send you a beard.
Well, let me tell you, I'm dying. But I'm not certain. I want it on my own ship. I'm dying of a man with a certain beard. But it's Lady Olivia Tide.
But sir, I have a question. If I had a pair of these boys and put them together, do you think they'd have children?
Yes, if they would get together and test it.
Well then, I'd like to play the fifth and put these two lovers together.
Well, you're pretty good at begging, aren't you?
Truly, sir. But I'm only begging on the beggar's behalf. The famous lover Priscilla, who became a beggar in her old age, they say. The lady Olivia's inside. I tell her where they come from. But who you are, and what you want, is beyond my knowledge. I'd say I'm not in my element, but those words are over you.
Well, this man is wise enough to play the fool. Well, to do this, you have to pay attention to the status and mood of the person with your money. This requires a lot of work. This is anyone's job. But on the other hand, twice pennies has ruined the reputation. But they said it is their playing the fool.
God bless you, sir!
You, sir!
God, thank you, sir!
And God see the place of it all!
I hope so, sir. I'm at service too.
Will you come in the house? My niece wants you to. If your business is with her.
I'm gone for you, Nisa. Oh, I mean, she's the destination of my voyage.
Try your legs then, sir. And put them in motion.
My legs stand out to be better than I understand yourself. They will withdraw your legs.
I mean to enter the house, sir?
Well, I'll answer you by walking in. But remittance is fated. Most gracious, accomplished woman. May the heaven rain orders upon you.
Sayus, as you have. Rain, orders, nice.
I'm bringing you our only message. It's only for your own willing and receptive ears.
I have to remember those.
Romulus the guard is going to be alone to him. Give me your hands, yeah? I offer you my greetings and my most humble service. What is your name? Sorry you should serve in the name of Brutus. My servant, sir. The world has gone downhill since those of you that they started passing over a continent. You're to oversee the servitude, not mine. But my master and lord is your servant. And all he has is yours too. So your servant, servant is your servant, my lady. Ask for him. I don't think about him. And as far as thoughts, I wish that they were black pages instead of little pictures of me. Well, honestly, my lady, I've come on his behalf to improve your feelings for him. Oh, please, I beg you. I ask you not to speak of him again. But if you would talk of another but not against him, I would rather hear them than even speak of him. Please. After the magic spell you cast on me last time you were here, I sent my trick to you. With a trick, I defeated myself, my servant, and you. I'm afraid. I must then accept your judgment of this act, which you probably condemn. For I forced the tribune to shame for the trigger and without your consent. What must you think of me? Haven't you taken my honor and stayed like a bear and let the hunts of your anger attack it? But I've shown the situation clearly enough for someone with intelligence to understand. My heart's in my speech. I can hide my passion, so let me hear you speak.
I pity you.
Let us step to it, love.
No, no, my lady. You must be mistaken.
That's not a step.
It's a common experience for us to pity our enemies.
Oh, I think it's time for me to smile again. How easy it is for the world to find something they don't have. But if I must be defeated, then barely to be defeated by another lady with an unholy one. See? The clock scolds me for wasting time. Don't worry, I won't keep pursuing you. But when you're older and wiser, your future wife will find the fine handsome husband. There she'll wake up home to us.
Then I'm off to the west, my dear lady. I wish you good fortune. We don't have a message for the Duke.
Stay, please, and tell them what you really think of me.
I think you're not who you think you are.
What was that? Is that true? I think the same thing of you.
Well then, you're right, my lady. I am not what I seem to be.
I wish you were what I want you to be.
Would that be better? Let me be what I am. I wish that they would, but for now I'm a fool.
Oh, look how beautiful it is, even in this anger and contempt. A murderer's guilt is easier to hide than feelings of love. Midnight is like nightmare for love. That's how brightly passion shines. Cesario, I swear by the roses of spring, by virginity, by honor, by truth, and by everything, that I love you. I love you so much that neither my wit nor my reason can hide my passion despite your pride. Your own conclusions here. Just because I'm moving you doesn't mean you shouldn't move me. Use your better logic to see that love is asked for good, but love is feeling even is better.
And I swear, by my own innocence and by my own youth, that I have only one heart and one love to give. And no woman is ever older, never will, except for me. Now, my dear lady, I won't force my master's passion into you. Farewell.
What the trouble you? What do you see when I come separate? So, I can't go anymore. I couldn't stay behind. Where the desire to go was sharper than a knife. It spurred me onward. It wasn't just love for you. Though that much might have inspired mine to go an even longer voyage. I was also worried what might happen to you in your travels. Since you don't know this area, it can be rough and inhospitable to a stranger without a guide or friend. My greeting love for you, combined with his fears for your safety, drove me to follow you.
My client, Tonya, though you shall give you thanks and thanks and thanks, but such goodness you will receive words. But if I had a web,
I was trying to make gratitude with money. Now, what should we do? Should we go see the boys missed out? We'll do that tomorrow, sir. First, we should find a place for you to stay. At night, it's a long way away. Please, let's go shut our eyes. With the morals and such, we deserve this. I hope you'll pardon me. I can't walk past this resident being in danger. Once in a battle at sea, I serve on the side fighting against Duke of Sino ships. And I distinguish myself enough that I might be recognized. If I were arrested here, they'd plainly answer for my deeds.
Then you must kill this man.
Your deeds were so glorious then. Though we are just to watch him slide over that bar. We could have seen yourself the matter by fair operations for the damage you did to them in battle. For the sake of maintaining our trade relations. Most of our city did. I was the only one who refused to pay Henry. That's why our great deal is on the friendship we got here.
Then walk around to what we shall do.
It's not a good idea for me, certainly. Wait, sir. Here's my purse. The best place to stay is in the cold, the elephant. It's in the suburbs to the south. I'll order a meal while spending time pleasantly and educate yourself by exploring the town. You can find me back at the elephant. Why should I take your purse though? Just give some drink and catch your eye and you want to buy. I have the feeling that your store will get money if you're flashing up for business practices.
Okay, your purse then. Thank you for that.
And meet me at the elephant.
I remember.
Ben? Yes, we'd love to come to you. For God's sake, why are you smiling at God and kissing hands so often?
Are you okay, Mongolia?
We take a last for you. But we'll not do that to
why are you acting with such ridiculous arrogance?
Don't be afraid of my greatness.
What
it has been written.
What do you mean by that, Malvolio?
Some are born great.
What?
Some achieve greatness.
What did you say?
And have some great stress upon them.
May heaven restore your sanity.
Remember who it was? Who complimented the yellow stockings?
Your yellow stockings?
And all we say in our closeness going up to lands.
Cross places?
Now go. You are sure to be becoming a gentleman. If you want to.
Am I a gentleman?
Not. Skip on to the servant.
This is surely insanity! I'm going to him. Go, Maria. Take care of this fellow here. Where's my cousin Toby? Let some of my servants take special care of Malvolio. I'll give half of my wealth to keep him from harm.
Oh, you see? This fits exactly to the letter. So it's all been instructed to take care of him, so that I can be rude to him. As she told me in the letter, you would decide to lower out yourself. She said, be rude to your companions and be mean to servants. Talk loud and nothing about politics. And make a habit of being unique in the century. She wrote how we should go about this. Such a solemn face and dignified demeanor. Speaking slowly and dressed like a distinguished gentleman. When she left, she said, take care of this fellow here. Fellow, not Malvolio. Not a servant, but fellow. Almost a partner. Why everything is coming together perfectly? No one can stand in the way of dreams. Where is she? In the name of all that's holy. Even if all the devils of hell are up together inside us. Even if a troop of demons possesses us, I still want to speak to her. Aha!
Tomorrow morning,
it's time, please.
Stone and fearlessly laid my honor and reputation at his stone.
There's something in me that loves my now, but that love is a winter and probably that indignors of the nation.
My master's passion for you is the same as yours and your passion for me.
Here, where this locket my picture is inside. Don't you feel so beautiful? And I think it has no voice to upset you with. And I beg you to come again tomorrow. What could you ask of me that I would deny? As long as I can retain my honor, I'll give you.
Nothing but this. Give your true love to my master.
How could I give him what I have already given to you?
I will release you from any obligation to me.
Farewell. A devil who will face to give my soul to him.
Hello, gentlemen.
Hello to you, sir.
Prepare yourself whatever fighting defenses you have. I don't know what you've done to insult him, but someone is full of defiance and bloodthirstiness towards you. And he waits for you at the end of the tournament. So draw your sword and prepare swiftly, for your opponent has all the skills, strength, and anger God can give to a man.
You must be mistaken, sir. I'm sure no man is ever going to fall. I can't even remember ever offending anyone.
You'll find the truth to be otherwise, I assure you. So if you value your life at all, be on your guard. For your opponent has all the strength, skill, and anger.
I'll go inside and ask for a protective escort from the lady. I'm no fighter. I've heard of some men in fixed blinders and tested bravery. Sir, maybe he's that kind of man.
No, sir. His fury comes from a very real insult you gave him. You won't be allowed to go back into the house unless you want to fight me. And if you're going to do that, you might as well fight him instead. So go into the garden. There's no way that you're going to avoid a fight today unless you want to give up your title as a gentleman and swear that you'll never carry a sword again.
Please, sir, can you kindly tell me who is he?
He is a knight, and he's knighted through foreign connections rather than his battle skills.
Lisa, do you know anything about this man?
I know the knight's furious with you, even if the three of one can fight with them, but I don't know any more details.
Lisa, what kind of man is he?
He's not made from the outside. By fighting, he always proves bigger. Indeed, sir, he's the most skillful, bloodthirsty, and deadly opponent that you can find in all of Malaria. If you wanna go see him, I'll try to appease him if you can.
Well, I'll be in your depth if you've been doing. I'm a man who rather deals with priests than with knights. I don't care if everyone knows that I'm not brave enough.
I've never seen, for his honor's sake, I pray to God that he keeps his promise.
I'll show you.
I swear to you, I wish none of this was happening right now.
Put away your sword. This young gentleman has offended you. Don't let the blame pass you. And if you've offended him, then I'll fight you on his behalf.
You, sharp guard, who are you?
Well, I'm his friend, sir. I will demand you for his sake, whatever he might say to me.
Well, if you're someone who accepts challenges, then I'll challenge you.
Stop!
We'll continue this game.
Put away your sword, please, sir.
I am dead, sir. And that's where I'm at.
What drugs? I guess gold as my horns. Yes, this is the right, we must pass land to the rain.
This is the man. Do your duty.
Tonyo, I arrest you on order of Pocino.
You've mistaken me for someone else, sir?
No, sir. Not to be. I know your face well, you cannot tell the sailor's cap on your head. Take him away. Enough of your mental mercy.
I must obey. This happened because I was killing you. There's nothing to be done now. Now that I've won. As for my first cup, what do you do?
Sir, I can lend you what I have. Do you kindness that you showed me earlier? I don't honestly think I have enough. But I can split all my fortune. Here's all I have, sir.
I suppose you could.
What money, sir? I've left it to
you. Thank you for the money.
He's so passionate about his words. It says that he truly believes in it. Well, imagination. Please be true. Please be true that I've been mistaken for my dear brother.
Come here, sir. Come here, Fabian. He whispered some wise sayings.
He called me Sebastian. Well, when I look in the mirror, I see my brother. The way he dresses and accessories well. Maybe it's because I am dead in him. If this is in fact true, then the heavens and the storms and fire and the ocean is full of them.
What a dishonorable puny boy! More cowardly than a rabbit! He shows his dishonesty in abandoning his friends in his time of need, then denying that he even knew. And as for his cowardice, ask for Fabian.
He's a coward, a true coward, religiously devoted to his cowardice.
Couldn't pray to God and keep his promise.
Don't draw yourself.
I can't wait to
talk. Are you trying to lie that my lady didn't send me to get you?
Go away! Go on! Rufus Fendel, leave me alone!
Good job giving up this act of yours, seriously!
No, I don't mind. I know he didn't send me to fetch you, and she didn't want you to speak to her.
Please, just hold it to someone else. You don't know me.
Stop my nonsense!
You must have heard that word used by some great man! And now he applies it to me, a jester. Spout my nonsense. This foolish world. It turns out, it's just an effeminate dandy. Please abandon your strange behavior. Tell me what I should spell to my lady. She will spell to me that you're coming. Yes, please, jester. Leave me alone. There's some money for you. If you stay longer, I'll give you something worse. I swear, you're a generous man. These wise men who give fools money earn themselves a good reputation. 14 years of payments.
it again? Done. Then take that and that and that! Is everyone getting mad?
Stop, sir! Or I'll throw your sword over the roof!
I'll tell my lady about this straight away. She wouldn't like anyone attacking Cesario. I wouldn't take money to deal some of yours.
Let me go! Come, sir! I won't let you go yet! You got him excited by a taste of battle! I'm gonna get rid of you! What do you do now? If you're dead, then you're right there! Then you draw your sword!
What? What? No! For then I'd have to spill an ounce or two of your impudent blood!
Stop, Dolby! I don't want you to stop!
Madam!
But it's always been like this with you! You are faithful wretch! You are only fit to live in the mountains! Escape Spartan civilization! Your good manners are necessary! Get out of my sight! Don't be offended, this is all you! Go away, you brute!
Olivia! No! Help me! Olivia!
Please, gentlemen, may your wisdom and your passion guide you through these uncivilized actions against you! House and let me tell you about the many pointless jokes like Mr. Octopus clumsily attempted. So you might come to love this one. You mustn't be. Don't deny me. That dog is so. He startled my heart. My heart which lives in you.
What is this going on? Where is the lady? I'm still mad. Or else, this is a dream. But if it's imagination, then let's forget my sense of reality. And dream like this? Then let me sleep!
I wish you would take my advice.
But then, I will.
Oh, say it, and do it too.
Is there? Is it a beautiful son? Is the girl she gave me?
can feel it and see it. And despite the weather confusion, I look crazy. But we shall find it then. We'll find the elephant. But he had a record me. And they told me he was taken for the talent. Look at me.
Good thing if you be so hasty. If you meet them, then come and bring this holy priest into the little chapel over there. Then you can swear your everlasting knuckle, make your marriage vows, and soon may each other's adopted mind. We can have a full-blooded ceremony and celebration that fits my social demands. What do you say?
Well, this good priest, we come with you. And once, shall be faithful, and be faithful forever.
Then, lead the way, good father, and may the sun shine brightly to recognize and bless this marriage.
Well,
Though the last time he saw, it was back in Vegas broken apart. He was the captain of a small flimsy ship, worthless by its size. But with the quiet people, he fought such a damaging battle against the fleets. Most noble warship that went admired to him, even in our bitter defeat. What's going on here?
Orsino, this is a stern Antonio with the ship the Phoenix and his heart on the and more than the tiger in the battle where Jamna feels our roots lost his death. We are rescued him in the field where he was recklessly growling as if we didn't care that we were looking for him. But sir, he was kind to me. He drew his sword for me earlier. He said some sort of thing that I didn't understand. Maybe it's because it's insane.
What foolish boldness are you to visit the enemies that you would rob and murder?
Orsino, noble sir, I must derise those names again. I've never been a thief or a buyer, though I've been the evil enemy for doing so in prison. I'm here because I've been bewitched.
When did you come to this town?
Today, my lord, for 3 months that you spent here every day and night together without a ring.
Look, an angel is walking on earth.
Oh, let's go, father!
You made an oath of eternal love, which has been made on the earth of man, ruled by holy kiss and strength of exchange of rings. I'm willing and accept this. My official capacity as a priest, all this new place only 2 hours ago.
Oh, you land of puppy! How much worse will you be when you're old and gray? That your own tricks will trick you? Farewell and take her! But go somewhere where you now will never meet again!
My lord, I promise! Oh, don't promise! Keep a little faith! You're fading me, even though you're so afraid!
For the love of God, someone give the doctor and send that to Sir Goblin away!
What's the matter?
He's cut my head open! Given Sir Goblin blood and tooth! For the love of God, help! I pay 40 pounds to get home right now!
Who has done this, Sir Andrew?
That Sario, the Duke's gentleman. He thought he was a coward, but she actually fights like the devil himself.
Master, what is Sario?
My God, here comes Sarius. He broke my head for no reason. I didn't do anything to you. And whatever I did, Sir Toby made me do that.
For God's sakes, why are you telling me this? You drew your sword to me without a valid reason. I spoke politely and didn't hurt you.
So blood had is an injury. Then you hurt me. I don't think you care at all about the blood head. Here comes Sir Toby. Let me tell you more about what happened.
Hello, gentlemen. How are you?
It doesn't matter. He has hurt me. And that's all there is to it. You drunken fool! Have you seen the surgeon?
No, he's drunk, Sir Toby. Since an hour ago. He's been cross-eyed since 8 in the morning.
Then he's a rogue! And I hate a drunken rogue. He spins and sways like he's doing a slow dance.
Who has done this, Sir Andrew?
I'll help you, Sir Toby. They'll bundle yourself together.
Will you help me? An ass, a boot, and a bastard, a gullible, skinny bastard!
Take him to bed and make sure his wounds are tended to.
Sorry, my son. I heard you're late. I couldn't have seen your brother. For once, I was out in St. Tibet.
You look like a stranger. Well, I tell that I offended you. Forgive me, sweet one. For the sake of the vows, we made so. One face, one voice, one mother pressing. It what is and is not. Is that me standing there? I never had a sister. Where from? Where are parents? What's your name?
I am from Misalad. My father's name is Sebastian and my brother's name is Sebastian too. Just like you, you drown. If the ghost can take a human form, then you must be here to frighten us.
I am a spirit indeed. I have a soul, but my spirit has the same and it flows.
My father went on his forehead.
Mine did too.
And he died the day of the Yomi Chan's 13.
Oh, that's that memory is still vivid to me. He did die in the midst of the 13th.
The only thing keeping us from being happy is my masculine clothes. And my disguise. And don't hug me until every circumstance, place, and time proves that I am one of them. Now, let me take you to the captain who has had my woman's clothes ever since and saved me so that I can serve this duke. Everything that happened to me since then includes this duke and his lady.
I'm sorry, but lady, you mistake me. You need an interpretation. Your love for Sonya was so easy for me, someone like me. You want to be a maiden. Don't be shocked. This body is mere noble. If all this is true, as the truth is seems to be brother and sister, the guy to share the cause of this body shared. Boy, it's said to me a thousand times that you never love a woman like love.
I promise you, I'll keep my promise like the fire is in the sun.
Your head, and let me see your
hands. The captain has first brought me to show how to do this thing. But he has some legal charge against him, because my boy is a servant to say. Here, release him. Bring my boy here. But no, now I remember. They say that the poor gentleman is mentally confused. My own destructive madness made me forget all about him.
Sonia, what's your name, Sonia? How close have you seen with you?
Yes, Sebastian.
Don't let us, Sonia.
How have you divided yourself in two? These two people are so identical as two halves of an apple. Which is Sebastian?
It's unbelievable.
Thank you. to end this event, let me introduce to you the people behind the scene. The production team. Dina Fruel and Dirat Gan Garcia, the curtain mans. Risha Marie Panganiban and Jean Isabel Narte, our costume designer. Emmer Angelo Lambon, the main makeup artist. Maria Romaline Ann Miralles, the production assistant. Production manager, David Carl Tan. Our sound technician, Jewel Rich I. Pehi. Our assistant stage manager and stage designer, Desiree Kate Quintana. And our stage designer, Janelle Elaine Zulueta. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce to you the cast of tonight's play. These individuals have dedicated their time and energy to bring this production to life with hard work and creativity of our production team, including our stage managers, costume designers, and set designers. Their expertise and vision have shaped every aspect of this production, and we are grateful for their contributions. To all the behind-the-scenes crew members who have worked tirelessly to ensure a seamless and memorable performance, from sound and lighting technicians to makeup artists and props masters, their efforts have been valuable. Next, let me introduce to you Jewel Rich Pehi, who played the role of captain. Christian Andrew P. Rosillo, who played the role of Furio. Felix D.P.L. Erce, who played the role of Antonio. John Cyrus Miguel Cuevas, who played the role of Fabian. Rylan Samuel Romero, who played the role of Valentin. Steven Allen Cordera and Brian Nilan Inohan, who played the role of Malvolio. Danae Alastino Barra and Felisa Maragacha, who played the role of Maria. Gresham Mirotaro and Josiah Unipon, who played the role of Sir Andrew Agichik. Riley Daniel Stephen Olivera, who played the role of Fumi. Now let me introduce the lead actors who portray the main characters. Let's begin with Cyrus John Baba, who played the role of Sir Toby Belch. Kirill Johan Ortiz, who played the role of Sebastian, and Sofia Martina Pereña as Lady Olivia. And last but not the least, Leonel Perey as Ursino and Jade Genesis Guyala as Viola and Cesario. And I, Angel Aiga Ilano, the director of 12th Night. Please us join me in giving a warm round of applause to the cast and crew of tonight's play. We are incredibly fortunate to have such talented individuals bringing this production to life, and we hope you enjoy the show. But before we end this night, I want to call onto the stage our very hard-working subject teacher who guide us through the months of preparation in this place, who boosts everyone's confidence and talents. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Kyla Marie Crawford.